Happy hump day, my people. Hope you guys are doing great today. Hope you are in a great space, a positive space, a place of faith, okay, or a space of faith, believing that all things are possible. Okay, so today we're going to be talking about self-love, 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 self-love. I've seen quite a few posts regarding self-love, okay? Some positive, some negative. So let's shoot down the middle. Let's get the whole kit and caboodle of self-love, all right? When you think about self-love, or when I think about self-love, I'll just talk about me. When I think about self-love, I think about how you nurture yourself, how you care for yourself, how you stop putting yourself last as opposed to putting everyone else first and yourself last. Many probably can relate to this. Growing up, a lot of times women are taught to take care of everyone else and then take care of you. That's just one scenario. As you grow older and you realize you've neglected yourself, whether it be physical health, emotionally, you begin to really go on this self-love journey where you're nurturing yourself more, okay? So when I think of self-love, that's what I think about. But there's also a self-love that can, it can hurt you. If you don't really understand that self-love is interdependent with all the other relationships that you have, it is not isolating. Okay, so some people use self-love as a way to isolate, to pull away from people. I don't want to deal with people. I'm good by myself kind of thing. When that connection part of us is longing for a connection, it is an innate, I don't want to use the word longing, but desire for us to be connected to others. It doesn't necessarily have to mean you have to have a person or be in a relationship. You could be connected with others in so many different ways, okay? So when the self-love drives you to isolation, when you are practicing avoidance, when you're not dealing with the things that are going on around you, you're just in kind of a hermit mode. That type of self-love can be damaging. Yeah, you're loving yourself, but you're isolating from everything and everyone else. Now, some people are very introverted, so they have a natural propensity to pull in. But at some point, even people that are introverted are going to connect with others. What would be most feasible? Or healthier, I would say, in just my opinion, to be healthier in your self-love journey is to be interdependent with other connections. Because the way you know your self-love is on point and working is when you're putting it to practice, when you're connecting with others. If you're not connecting with others, your self-love is not even being sharpened, because self-love is about honoring yourself. If the only person that you're with all the time is you, and yeah, you're honoring yourself despite your isolation, you understand. But when you connect with other people and you still honor yourself despite the connection, if that makes sense, okay? So honoring yourself alone is wonderful. Self-care alone is wonderful, but you're gonna really know you're honoring yourself if you're connecting to other people. So self-love, a healthy self-love, is interdependent, okay? It's interdependent. You may not be a person that ever has a person. And let me say this, that is okay. Don't let people make you feel like, if I don't have a person, then I'm going to live alone, or I'm going to die alone. That won't happen. As long as you are interdependent with other connections, because there are many types of connections you can have without having a person, okay? I just wanted to share my thoughts on self-love healthy self-love and isolating self-love. Find where you fit in. Get in where you fit in and continue on this journey of nurturing yourself and also being interdependent in your connection with others. I will see you guys next time. Have a fantastic day. Toodles.